Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is our Nicholas, your host today. We are going to do a couple video reviews showing off a couple of the games that one of our very own cat captains had some fun in and got a little excited with. Alman, actually, he is here today. If he wants to introduce himself.
Hello.
Okay, that's Dark Firewolf for you. And this is just, we are playing with Iowa and Missouri here, the screenshot, because this is our first playing around with doing after-action video with Wargaming's wonderful replay feature. So we'll just give it a couple minutes to load up here. And so this first game we are going to look at is he was playing a ranked battle with the Belfast. And it's probably his third or fourth game in the Belfast after just getting it. Okay, correction. Second, which he could actually speak up and say it himself instead of pointing fingers at me. In results, unfortunately, we don't have screenshots or anything. We kind of forgot about that, and we're going to start with the next second video. We actually do have some screenshots for the end result. But got about 80,000 damage and high caliber. So he was quite happy, and so the video is about to start. I will probably fast forward unless Mr. Firewolf here wants to say anything and join in. Gotta wait until the game gets in. Unfortunately. I kind of wish they would finish up and polish off the replayability of World of Warships so we can do standard replays somewhat like World of Tanks instead of their questionable content quality.
Yeah, unfortunately in that game their carrier was quite talkative.
Action stations. Well, I'm guessing he's probably interacted in... Oh, I guess there isn't a gym. I don't think I have
our carrier was Jim. He was.
Oh, okay. So he's probably with carriers in ranked play. They will probably face each other an awful lot since North America doesn't really have many carriers playing, at least not at tier 7. I know when I did ranked play at the tier 6 level, I did bring my independence a couple times. But we will fast forward it a little bit to get to the actual action. So they're all headed to B. Carrier sending out his planes to hunt for the enemy carrier and give spotting for B. Unfortunately, I haven't quite figured out how to unlock the camera, so we will only be seeing his movement. For the most part, there's not too much jerking around. So, Belfast is considered overpower.
First game in it, I did not see how people considered her overpowered.
And now?
I find that ship quite overpowered after playing with it a bit.
Okay, I guess I didn't speed it up quick enough. Don't want to wait 3 minutes just for...
I didn't actually do much of anything until they're destroyed, I think. If I remember correctly, they came up around in that front of me a bit, and that's actually when I started firing at things.
Hey, he's giving you previews before, instead of letting us talk about it as it happens. But for the most part, I've now watched this video kind of twice. The first time standard speeds, and second time playing trying to figure out the controls. Second time was fast forward just to get some of the information at the end. Doing the right thing with Belfast, getting in position, using an island to shoot over it. He is still detected right now, and it's not showing why, which would probably be a DD. Slow down, pop smoke. Probably would have hit radar myself about an hour just as he entered smoke, because he was obviously spotted before the big ships were in spotting range. There are a couple misplays potentially, but, you know, it turned out well for the team, so... And he had a lot of fun.
It was actually a quite enjoyable game. It was a lot of fun.
I think I was busy with helping somebody here at the shop and just came in. Oh my god. So, that's probably a fairly right play to do, is activate the sonar. Just in case the Mahan sends off torpedoes. Of course, I would have been expecting it since the first time when he was spotted. And he's also getting out. I guess that could be a second misplay there. Because I was thinking the first time I watched this that he... The radar, so Hydra was not going off. Yeah, he could have stayed in the smoke longer. He dealt with that.
And I made the misplay and I saw the Sims on the map, and I was going to go after him, which could have turned out very bad because I had to present broadside to the Shinehorst.
Yeah, see, this is one, he overexposes himself a little bit, but it paid off. The enemy kind of failed to take advantage of his overexposing. Because just a couple good hits from the Eisenhower or Shinehorst could have killed him. Of course, right now the Shinehorst actually has islands between him. But and their destroyers were very fixated, which is an issue.
Well, if you look at it, most of my team was too, where they were all heading. They were all heading into the enemy carrier.
True. Because the Sims could have fired torpedoes at you, and actually probably made you had to respond to that, and then continue firing his guns at the carrier. Because that would have probably helped the Sims out an awful lot more.
Instead of just focusing on the carrier, where that was a lot more of a threat. Yeah.
I think he's firing AP, too. Which, at that angle, he's not going to do anything.
He has to hit first to do anything.
True. But he did. He was getting some hits. I don't know if you're hearing... Oh, you probably can't. You're not hearing the sounds. That's right. So in this situation now, he's trying to maneuver and give the carrier some supporting fire. The big issue is he was just running regular consumable smoke and, you know, cooldown. And then his one misplay here, kind of, you know, the enemy starting to shoot at the carrier instead of him. He wanted to pop smoke for the carrier, but ended up, since he was going full speed, outran the carrier. And you'll see in a little bit where he ends up having some issues trying to re-smoke.
But at the same time, also, if you look at it, those battleships could have completely took me out of the game right there. I pulled a dumb move and went broadside.
Yeah, the misplay on their part, because they could have taken you out. They were too fixated on the carrier. Which, with the carrier having to run like this, he's not going to do as much. And the rest of his team is now turning around and going for A-cap, and none of the enemy team is even looking at B-cap. They're all carrier, bling bling, let's blow somebody up. Of course, maybe that other enemy carrier had a good game last time, and those were some of the same players. Well, actually, it's not that you put the smoke down early, it's the fact that you weren't in position to where you could truly take advantage of it. So it was by that time, you know, the positioning of you, and if you had slowed down a little bit, but the problem is if you had slowed down, those battleships might have also decided to target you. So it's kind of a catch-22. You tried. You really did try. Of course, I think he's burning, or... Yep, enemy carrier's all complaining now. I was on a winning streak. Yeah, it's kind of one thing about playing. Where's the enemy carrier? Playing ranked battles is you sometimes do see a lot of the same people over and
over.
Yeah, and that's one thing I'm not liking. So there's a spotter plane spotting him, but you don't see the spotter plane at all.
And then here's my favorite feature about the Belfast, how quick she actually can get her turns going.
Yep. Feature of the British cruiser line. Excellent turning radius. Well, not necessarily excellent turning radius, but the fact that she can accelerate and turn well. But we also, I did talk him into doing the full, both turn, rudder shift changes for the Belfast and...
Which put me down to, I think, if I remember correctly, 4.6 second rudder shift time, which is comparable to most of the destroyers. I think it's like 2 seconds less than some of them.
And a little lag there in the replay for some reason. I think that point was actually just the replay, because I want to say it last time it wasn't showing.
Yeah.
There was another point that there was a couple jitters here and there. We've had some internet connectivity issues here at the shop, and though for the past 2 days I think it's been more the... I think he probably could have gotten the repair off to stop the fires, but, you know, to his own.
Then I'm pretty sure the secondary hit would have finished me off before I could have fired.
But so just shy of 80,000 damage. You know, I don't think there was any unknown damage that we weren't aware of. High caliber, 6 incapacitation, 734 shots, 3 secondaries, and 6 fires. Fairly new, as you said, second game in the Belfast. So, hell, and the game that went from, why is this overpowered to, ooh, I like the ship. So, hope you guys enjoyed this one. Give us a minute, and we will switch over to the next video. And I'm actually going to pause the video recording and just, I don't remember how to pause. Let's see. Oh, that's not the right button. So maybe this one? Nope. Well, let's try this one.
One interesting thing about this game is I had the first command their skill where it let me know how many actually guns were targeting me. That was the only skill I went into this game with.
Okay, I don't remember how to pause, so you guys will just have to deal with the the minute or two of switching videos. Sorry, don't normally pause my recordings, and I don't want to end it because then I have to merge the videos, and that's more work, and I want to get these up and running on YouTube for you guys. So this is the next game. It's an Anshan that he feels that he should have died multiple times, and but had some fairly nice results, and we do have screenshots for the end results. We will show you afterwards. So, any thought process, comments, or concerns?
Not really. The Anshan is... It's an interesting destroyer.
By the way, anybody who doesn't know what the Anshan is one of the Pan-Asian premium ships. It is the Tier 6 destroyer that is very similar to one of the Soviet destroyers. She has one of the unique special features of her is that her camo provides an increase of 100% free experience. And so that's the unique aspect of her. the also instead of having the typical 4 kilometer torpedo range that I think they give her 8.2 or something like that. So she actually has okay range torpedoes, but they're slow. And she does have some of the very similar Soviet characteristics of slow turning guns, you know, spotty and all that is kind of meh. So she's usually played more as a second line. I personally have not quite figured her out, and I think I'm just always playing her too aggressive. I also have the Yolang, and I love the Yolang, and she's basically a slightly worse version of Benson from my understanding, but I've had a lot of fun, and for some reason I feel that Anshan should work like the Yolang, but yeah. Anyhow, this is obviously a regular battle, not a small one. And
Yeah, I find you have to play the Anshan very defensively. Otherwise, she just kind of gets outgunned and overpowered, even with her speed. And the turning that most destroyers have.
Well, Soviet DD play. And obviously, this is before the server patch 6.3. That's currently in testing. So, some ships have stealth fire, some doesn't. And we'll see how those changes, and that's the reason why we're kind of doing these videos this way instead of waiting for me to do something else, because I don't want to miss the chance of watching these replays and talking about them and getting them online, since these were not recorded live. So we're talking to you live. Of course, you got two of us instead of just one.
Yay!
He sounds so excited, doesn't he?
But this is where things started to get interesting. I actually started to base another Anshan, which in the beginning of the game I didn't realize there was actually another Anshan in the game. So I was caught off guard with the fact that I was fighting the same ship I was actually using.
And by the way, I have actually not watched this video, so this is my first time watching it. I just remember hearing all his screaming of excitement afterwards. But one big thing, smoke. Smoke is magnets for torpedoes. So try to always be facing the enemy so the likelihood of you getting hit is narrow or minimizes. And we did play a game the other day where the two of us... you were in your Anshan.
Once again, I was in the Anshan, yeah.
And what was I in?
You were in the Tier 6 German. Destroyer.
German? No, Soviet. So, the regular... The regular tier 6, not the premium one. I have that one too.
And see here what I did is I fired my torpedoes off the lander. It was just more of a thing to get him to maybe open himself up for fire from others. And yeah, I couldn't pay attention. I kind of looked over at him and fire wasn't really watching my torpedoes. Since there was no DD to fire at.
The one thing I do have to say is you should probably need to do a better look around for what the enemy is around for torpedoes.
No. The thing is, I knew the mine destroyer was spotted.
I was actually referring to the Grimgotchi here in this battle.
Torpedo hits on the lantern, swiping it. I don't know what I was doing, firing like that.
Yeah, I probably would have stayed with firing at the one on the left. Because technically, Minakazi is a far more dangerous ship because she has a much faster reload time.
But I saw a close to DD and figured I could get her out of here before anything happened with her.
Kill number two. And already at 31,000 damage. Of course.
Now moving on to Minakaze.
was... I played very defensively around A, and noticed we haven't capped it yet, with all these destroyers that have been in there.
Actually, Minakaze, she's changed. I was thinking of the Kamikaze and Kamikaze R. They have the ridiculous. But I think Minakaze still has fairly, maybe 50-second reload. Downside potential with the new changes for 6.3 is destroyers might not be acting like that as much anymore.
Well, it won't affect the Anshan too much because she can't do any self-fire anyways. Without a 10-point commander, at least.
I'm not positive. I don't have my Anshan trained up either. But we'll find out. Well, it won't matter come the... And some misplay there because those torpedoes, half of them will hit the island. Which actually, one thing, try not to do because an aware captain will notice the torpedo results on the island and know that there are for sure torpedoes coming in. But he's already doing better than I typically do in the ship because I normally get blown up right off the bat. Because I play her.
And a capture. Actually, if you look at it, none of the torpedoes hit the island.
I think one did.
But unfortunately, they all missed.
Yeah. It happens. Wonderful Fubaraki. Okay, totally butchered the name.
You mean Fubuki?
Yeah. I just want to take her out to the cabana.
No, admittedly, the Anshan doesn't have the greatest reload, but it's not ridiculous at all either. It's something I have noticed.
Yeah, well, she's the copy of the Soviet DD. Number one skill to get with,
Anshan.
No, any DD is to make sure that you can,
continue moving and turning with the, even when your engine and rudder are knocked out. That's an issue we have a lot with her, is engine and rudder issues.
But I've also noticed sometimes that for some reason they don't always work. I don't know if that's... Of course, I play a whole bunch of different TDs, so it might be something to do with me changing captains and not realizing it. But rudder and engine are very important for DDs. And there's the Soviet overpowered ship that will no longer be as overpowered. So I wonder if with the nerf that they're giving, if they're going to suddenly start putting her back on sale. And I finally came across a video where people actually truly talked about what's so overpowered about her. She has potentially, with a fully trained commander, something like a 4-kilometer stealth radius. So that's kind of why she's so nasty. Almost did a notcher there.
I noticed myself, I relied on torpedoes with her a lot because of the turning that she has. She has a very slow turning turret, which makes things difficult with her. So that's why I found when I was doing turns, I had the torpedoes, and that's where I got cracking. But when I was waiting for my guns to turn, I generally just fired the torpedoes off to have something out to potentially get rid of the enemy ships.
So 5 kills, only 4 torpedo hits, 38 regular gun hits, a devastating strike.
One defend, two fires, three incaps, and defend.
Yeah, I think I had done full turret rotation changes on her, and it still does not make any improvement. Well, okay, it does make some improvement, but just not worth... I've debated about changing her setup. But, yeah, the other game we played the other day...
Two destroyers hidden in smoke. I fired both sets of my torpedoes off. wasn't expecting much from it since destroyers generally avoid torps fairly well.
Yep. His torpedoes hit and killed both destroyers, and mine ended up having no targets to hit. Unfortunately, we didn't really... Well, yeah, we could probably find the video, but... That sounds like too much work for me.
Wasn't the greatest game either, though.
Yeah, it's still a fun result.
Yeah, especially the double strike.
That was an unexpected start off.
Especially since they had knocked out your engine.
Yeah.
But this looks to be one of those games where pretty much all of the non-destroyers are getting hit by torpedoes. And I just realized you're boosting away to go help find that Minakaze, I'm guessing.
Yep. Yeah, I decided to help out our New Mexico with the Minakaze since I was trying to keep at least the big gun game
to help take care of the battleships.
I'm not sure what this guy was talking about.
When he said that.
Who knows?
But seeing that the New Mexico died, I did a full turn around and went back into A and helped defend.
Since Afuso was almost full health, and we have a full health destroyer basically, but our Baron was running.
Now this is where I was surprised, since the Fletcher is an American DD, their guns are a lot better than the Anshan's.
Not the Fletcher, Farragut.
Oh, Farragut. Still an American DD.
She might have been stock, too. But still, her guns are 6-second reload, I think.
And they turn faster than mine.
She could well easily outgun me.
Actually, if we... No, she's a fully upgraded one. It looks like she has some missing gun and additional AA in the back, so she's C-hole. Somebody might just not realize that...
And firing AP.
Apparently that's the thing to do now. A lot of people have been doing that.
And this is the part where I got all excited. You see, I fired torpedoes at Fuso. I did not expect to get the Farragut. This is where I made the mistake. I didn't want to be broadside, but at the same time, I kind of panicked here with the Fuso so close that this is where I died because I came around and he got...
Oh, no, it's not.
Yeah, that's where I died.
But you're getting shot from multiple directions, so that's understandable. Yeah. And you got Battle Hero, which means you got multiple... heroic rewards over so many encounters during your account, so another congratulations. So I don't know how much more of the video we have here, but let's go ahead and speed it up a little bit so people can see. I think he's... Just looking around, I see what's going on. Yeah, the slight lack in movement was him. Oh my god.
Yeah, I was quite shocked I got the random torpedo hit on the destroyer. I did not expect that.
And he's definitely jumping around an awful lot. Normal speed. And our pink Molotov.
I think he's actually the one that won this game for us, too. If I remember correctly.
But unfortunately, I don't remember.
Yeah. Molotov's an interesting... Actually, once you started to get the Molotov, well, Molotov's the premium, but, the... God, I can't think of what it is. The T-34 Tier 5 Soviet cruisers, they change their game style and play, and I kind of... It's weird. I hate the higher tier American cruisers that lose their turret, but on the Soviet ones, I actually enjoy their ships. But then again, you also have, you know, like 5 extra kilometers to shoot at, too.
Yeah, this has been my best game so far on the Anshan.
I think we've played well over... I don't know how many games we've actually played in her. Still haven't really figured her out to this point.
Well, maybe that means we need to do a night of just playing the Anshan and figuring her out. Of course, that means we're sticking to one ship instead of jumping around like we normally do.
Yeah.
Or maybe I just need to stick with her for a bit and figure it out.
I think it's a destroyer, you have to pick an area and defend that area.
Well, she's Soviet, and I haven't really played a whole lot of Soviets. Well, technically, I'm up to the tier 8. I do have the... Actually, I don't even remember the Ognoboy or whatever. Oh. But before the Soviet change, I hated their tier 5. I was so happy to get out of it, and I got to tier 6. And then they moved things around. But... They just require you to think more.
Yeah, as I was pointing out, I think I was talking to one of my teammates about her because they mentioned that they heard she was a difficult ship to play.
One thing I do think Wargaming needs to change is they changed when you hit the edge of the map, they do give you negatives now. And I know this has nothing to do with the current gameplay and all that, but...
I mean, it kind of did, just hit the edge of the map.
But they don't really give you notification that you are hitting the edge of the map. So they have this little grayed-out sign that says your engines are going to slow down or something like that. But there's no... You know, if they're going to give you some kind of penalty, there should be something that flashes and the time frame. And, you know... Or they could do what they did with World of Warplanes, where you lose control of your ship, and it's from the angle in which you... But that could be used so nastily, too. Throws your ships and makes you go out of the zone and immediately flips you around and comes back in the direction you were coming in from. Yeah, I guess that's a bad idea. Because I just realized somebody could use that to surprise the hell out of somebody and get a drop or screw people over, too, with it.
Especially if you're a battleship and you do that, and your guns, you have them turned the other way, and you've got something that's really close with torpedoes, you could do that and then do a full salvo at close range and basically use the large guns to wipe out the ship.
So, my thought, they need to give you some a little bit notification. The first time I ever noticed it, I was sitting there on the edge, and I, by the time I realized what was going on and saw the little notification because it was so grayed out on everything, I couldn't turn. So I basically died because I could not turn. So here's the end result. 75,000 damage, 7 torpedo hits, defense, multiple rewards, 4.5k, and then we need to go over...
Over 300,000 credits made as well, 454 free experience, which is quite a bit.
Top of the leaderboard with almost, what is it?
500
experience, 700 experience above the other person.
And a whole lot above the top of the leaderboard on the enemy team.
Yeah, well, that's... they lost, so... But they overall, they had some decent players there, because they're... You know, well, okay. Yeah. But who knows. Anyhow, so the next one here is the overall damage result. 53,000 of her, of the 75, so a lot of torpedo damage, so really good. Torpedo run there.
A lot of cleanup kills and a lot of destroyer kills. I believe why the damage is quite a bit lower.
Unfortunately, whatever you were mousing over kind of covered up the damage, potential damage, fires caused, that kind of thing that we can't see there. But did spot 19 torpedoes. I do kind of like that. I try to, at least with my carrier, I like knowing that it was useful in spotting torpedoes. And then the actual money. So out of 66, made 333. Any final words, parting thoughts?
No, not really.
Yeah, well, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Give us your thoughts and comments. Like if you enjoyed it. Dislike if you really dislike the content. Give us, you know, we're obviously a work in progress here at Tekoa Games, and we hope to streamline this and make it any of and all of our videos a little bit more professional and to where people enjoy it. Thank you very much, and have a wonderful day.